everyone. I'm Colin Murphy. I'm a Senior Product Marketing Manager at Microsoft, and I'm joined here today by Elaine, Senior Program Manager with Azure SQL Database. So Elaine, welcome.
Thank you very much for having me.
And today we're doing, Elaine's going to teach us something very, very simple, just basic native backup and restore in Azure SQL Database Managed Instance.
Yes, thanks Colin. So essentially what we're going to look at today is how we do native backup restores from on-prem into managed instance. And the major reason why this is important is because this functionality wasn't previously supported in Azure SQL Database. So it really is a big enabler for customers that are trying to sort of migrate legacy applications that have databases that are sitting in SQL Server today. So if we come and look at the code here, you'll see in my Management Studio, I'm connected to two different databases. So the one here is a SQL 2017 that's running on a VM. Now that VM could be on-premise or it could be in Azure as it is in this case. And we can sort of verify that quite easily. You can see here, if I run this, you can see, I'm in the wrong context. Let's go to this one. Run that. You'll see here that this is my SQL Database MI demo, but this is the VM and it is running SQL Server 2017. Right. So the first thing that you've got to do when you're doing these backups is you have to go create credentials. So your credentials are essentially a way for SQL to understand how to get into a blob store. And the reason that that's important is because we only support backups and restores from URL for managed instance. So you can see here that I have credentials into this blob over here, which is basically the SQL DB MI store in the backups folder specifically. So all I have to do is execute the backup script to go do a backup of this tutorial database, and it'll go do it straight into that blob store. Now we can also go look here just so that we can show you what it looks like when it hits manage instance. We can go look, this database that we just did a backup of is sitting in compatibility 110, right? So it's older than the instance that it's running in. If we then come over to our managed instance, and we can look at that quite easily, you'll see here we're connected to a managed instance, and you can see that by sort of the way that that name is structured, but you can also see by the version that this is SQL Azure. So it's an evergreen environment. It's running the latest SQL code base. There is no more like additions or versions like 2017 or anything again. So the first thing we're gonna do, we're just gonna make sure that the database doesn't exist. And then exactly the same thing as I did with the SQL 2017 instance, we can come look here and you'll see I have the credentials for that exact same blob store where we did the backup to sitting over there. Then we can run very simply a restore operation like that from the blob store. And this will take a little bit of time to run because essentially it has to go fetch it. It has to validate that backup. And then the minute that backup has been restored, we can go and look at the same sort of characteristics that we did on the SQL 2017 server. And you'll see that Managed Instance has actually maintained the compatibility level of that database, which is scoped down, right? So that's a very important key differentiator, especially for customers who are trying to bring their legacy applications up with them into Azure. So maintaining the older versions of SQL is kind of a really big part of managed instance and how we try and make it easy for customers to move up into Azure. So we just have to wait. It's probably going to take about another 10 seconds or so.
So Elaine, this is just a great way for doing like just an offline migration for a legacy system, right? And then my other question is the URL. We're doing it to a URL. That's mainly for security reasons because managed instance is in a VNet, correct?
Well, that's part of it. So the security is definitely a part of it, which is why we use the URLs. But the other bigger part of it is really around because managed instance is isolated inside its own VNet, it doesn't have the concept of, it has no way of understanding how to connect to a file store like you would in traditional SQL. So in normal SQL, you would be able to say, oh, well, I want to go store my backup on this network drive and then be able to restore from it. Managed instance wouldn't know how to get there because it doesn't reside on normal infrastructure like a normal database would.
Makes sense.
So here on the demo, you can now see we finished, took about a minute or so to run that backup. And then if we come look and we do the exact same query that we did on the previous one, you'll see the tutorial database is back online now. And we've preserved the compatibility at 110 for this database. And really, it's that simple, right? Like it's not harder than that to do native backup restores. So you can easily move existing data assets. You can move them up into the cloud. And there's no more additional overhead than what you would have done for sort of years on-prem using SQL Server.
Great. Thanks, Elaine. Thank you, everyone. So thanks, Elaine, for showing us how easy it is to do backups on Azure SQL Database Managed Instance. So hope you like this, like us, and subscribe to this channel, and we'll share a URL with you where you can learn more information. Thank you very much.